Hello, West Potomac. It's me, Ms. Millard, your principal, and I really hope and pray that all Wolverines are safe and are staying healthy. We are in one of the most trying times in modern history. I appreciate all of you and your patience as we navigate these uncharted and unprecedented waters. I know that some of you may have been frustrated by the pace at which the school system has developed plans for and next steps. However, I am also sure that you understand the depths and the breadth of this work. Now we are going into the third week of closure and can begin to enact the distance learning plan. It is my goal with this presentation to give you an overview of the plan, timelines, and expectations. I would like to preface all of this with the fact that this work is new and untested, and it will not be perfect. It will evolve over time, and we must be patient and give grace to our students, faculty, and to ourselves. So with that, let's think about one thing that you've been grateful for over the past 2 weeks. I found myself waking up every morning being grateful for many things, like my immediate and extended families being safe and healthy, the fact that I have a home, food, healthcare, and an income. Things that I admit I've taken for granted in the past, and that I am keenly aware many others in my community cannot take for granted. So just think about the things that you've been grateful for over the past 2 weeks, and let that ground us as we move forward in this journey. The Distance Learning Plan, or DLP, is a learning experience where teachers and students are separated by place. They communicate asynchronously through printed or electronic media and/or through technology that allows them to communicate synchronously. Synchronous learning is where the teacher will be providing ongoing instruction of essential skills and knowledge within the content. Blackboard Collaborate Ultra will be used to accomplish this. This work is teacher-directed. Asynchronous learning will also have virtual office hours for students to get help from their teachers, to work independently or in groups, utilizing Google Classroom. This work is student-directed. The goals of the DLP are to provide continuity of learning, ongoing connections between teachers and peers, and a sense of normalcy and routine during this stressful time. We must acknowledge that there are several ongoing challenges with distance learning that have been mitigated as much as possible over the past 2 weeks in developing this plan, to include inequitable access to technology and connectivity, meeting the needs of special populations, and staff members, students, and families with challenges of working from home. The first weeks of closure have been about student and family choice. We are now moving into a more structured learning time. The basic components of the teacher-directed experiences are scheduled synchronous chats using Blackboard Collaborate, posted assignments to be completed asynchronously, and advertised office hours for individualized instruction and support. This week, teachers will reconnect with their students, update grades in SIS, update Google Classroom and Blackboard, identify work to improve grades for third quarter, and attend professional development sessions. Students will have the opportunity to finalize their third quarter work assigned up until March 13th, the day of closure. Students will have until April 24th to complete this work, at which time grades will be finalized for third quarter. The responsibilities of teachers in the DLP plan includes collaboratively planning synchronous and asynchronous learning activities, leading virtual instruction, setting office hours for individualized student support, reaching out or working with other staff to reach out to students and families who need additional support, responding to parent or student communication promptly within 48 hours, and participating in staff meetings, collaborative team meetings, and professional development as scheduled. Fairfax County has established a virtual bell schedule for high school. This is the schedule for West Potomac. It may look slightly different from other schools, but the basic bell schedule, daily student expectation, and times are the same. We are adding an optional wellness block during our third period advisory. We are planning to use that time for support programs from Student Services, College and Career Center, library, activities, student government, and our health and wellness professionals. We will develop a schedule of what students could choose to take part in. This will also be a weekly developed schedule for students. We are hoping to offer after-school activities such as club meetings and athletic meetings. Students are expected to have approximately 45 to 60 minutes of virtual teacher-directed learning per class per day. They are also expected to work 45 to 60 minutes per student-directed slash choice learning per class per day. This is the Wednesday-Friday office hour schedule for West Potomac. During this asynchronous time, teachers will be available via Blackboard Collaborate Ultra to answer questions and provide individualized learning opportunities. This is student-directed and student-choice. Each department is scheduled for a 90-minute block of time. Each content teacher team will be responsible for making sure a content area teacher is available to support students within these time blocks. Think of it as late bus time. It is not a time for new synchronous instruction. It is a time for help and reteaching as a student determines their needs. Centrally created resources for students and staff have been and will continue to be available on Blackboard. As guided by the Virginia Department of Ed and approved by the Fairfax County Public Schools School Board on Friday, FCPS has developed an overall grading policy. More detailed information as to the calculation of grades and accountability for attendance and fourth quarter will follow at some point this week. I will provide all updated information as I receive it. The focus here is that all students will have an opportunity to close out third quarter and improve their grade. Fourth quarter on student report cards will reflect a no mark or NM, which will not reflect on their transcript and GPA. This came as direct guidance from the Virginia Department of Ed. However, fourth quarter learning will positively influence the final transcript and GPA marks based on student demonstrated trends in mastery of essential learning objectives. This is stressing the importance of students engaging the distant learning opportunities that will begin on April 14th toward a positive impact on their final grades. This is the projected timeline for the remainder of the virtual school year. Please refer to fcps.edu for all DLP updates and information.
You're broken down and tired.
Thank you all for your time and attention. Thank you to the parents, students, and community members who have reached out to us with encouraging words and offers of help and support. Although it doesn't surprise me, it continues to overwhelm me how caring our community is, how we all mobilize in times of difficulty, and how we are so strong and resilient. We are Wolverines, and we will rise and get through this together. Please stay safe, stay home if you can, and when you are out, practice social distancing. I can't wait until we are all together again.
When the silence is in quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe, and I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet and move mountains, bring it to its feet and move. Mountains, and I'll rise up, I'll rise like the day, I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again, and I'll rise up, high like the waves, I'll rise up, in spite of the ache, I'll rise up, and I'll again.